standardized mobile driver's licenses. And the reason why we say, okay, well, what is Apple going to do? Because the stories that we mentioned before, even Apple mentioned the ability to save driver's license to your Apple wallet. That's Apple wallet. That's proprietary. That's to Apple. There are four states that you mentioned that have signed on to use Apple's version of the mobile driver's license. It'll be interesting to see what Apple does that this international organization has standardized a mobile driver's license. And they have some pretty dope features as to why Apple may want to join in on this versus creating their own version of a driver's license, because this international standard organization of standardization actually has put out these features that they say is more private than an actual physical driver's license. And I'll just read through some of these features. It only shares relevant data. So if somebody asks for your ID and, you know, they, you know, for purposes of identification, all they'll be able to do is use it to identify who you are. They won't be able to, you'll have to give them explicit consent to share. So they can't just lift any other information off your driver's license, like where you live, you know, who you're married to, if you're an organ donor. That ain't what's important for what they need. Then you can only share that relevant data. You consent to share. You don't have to give up your phone. I think one of the things with the Apple Wallet driver's license is you may have to, right. With this version of the mobile driver's license, you don't have to give up your phone. They can scan your thing and then do what they have to do. Notification of data retention. So if you have to prove your verification and somebody scans your mobile driver's license and they try to store it or save it, you know, you'll get notification that they have to do it and you have to consent to them doing it. No unique identifiers. So, you know, if somebody tries to, you know, track you to find out, like try to sell your information to, you know, marketers or whatever the case may be, it's anonymized and unique. So they can't create a profile. They can't track where you're going to figure out your habits or anything like that for whatever reason. Again, you know, if they can do it, they will. So this standardization just locks that down before anybody even tries, right? And there's no connection needed. So the data is shared directly between devices. It's not going off to some server somewhere. You know, the people who, whether it be TSA, whether it be police officers, whether it be healthcare, whatever the case may be, they don't need some sort of connection. It just goes, the information goes from device to device. So all that to say, since there now is a standardized mobile driver's license, will Apple do their own thing and try to proprietize this thing to where, you know, if you want to use Apple's version, it's going to be different? Or are they going to, you know, jump on the wagon of this already internationally standardized version? So that's the question, which is why maybe they've held off on releasing that to maybe play ball with this group.
Yeah, maybe. And maybe it's one of those things where they got some insider information to say, hey, something's coming down the pipeline. You may want to pump your brakes a little bit to see exactly what this is and see how well they play together, if they play together at all. So it'll be interesting to see. And the features sound pretty dope. And I know as someone who was always worried about privacy and security, you know, your driver's license has a lot of key information, you know, to know that it's going to be protected is always a good thing.
Right.